Have you ever had your internet cut out right in the middle of something important? Now, if you're using Starlink, that's the satellite internet that works almost anywhere, you probably already know how amazing it is when it works. But like any internet, sometimes it slows down, drops out, or gets blocked. That's where Home Assistant comes in. Home Assistant is a free, open source software you can run on a small computer like a Raspberry Pi. It lets you connect and control all your smart devices in one place. And the best part here is that it can also talk to Starlink. So you can create automations, which are little rules that make your Starlink smarter. But most people think Starlink's biggest issue is just losing connection. Actually, that's the least impressive thing we can automate. The real magic? Catching dish obstructions, overheating, and even putting Starlink to bed at night. And that's what I'll show you today. Four useful and fun Home Assistant Starlink automations. But before that, the first step is to add your Starlink in Home Assistant. I'm using Starlink Mini, but the specific model doesn't really matter. Oh, Starlink devices should work great and in the same way. Once it's in, you see sensors for ping, dropouts, dish obstructions, and more. From there, the fun begins. This is my test Home Assistant setup, and adding Starlink in it is very easy. I'll just press the C button on my keyboard and I'll type integrations. Then I'll select navigate integrations and I'll add a new integration. In this dialog, I'll search for Starlink. Here it is. And now, before I proceed further, at this point, I will have to double check that my Home Assistant is in the same network as Starlink. In most cases, Home Assistant should be connected to internet through your Starlink device. And if that's the case, you just have to click on submit here. This is the default IP address of the Starlink browser. And this is the default port that should be used for this integration to work, so I don't have to change anything. If you did some changes in your Starlink router, if you change your subnets, mask, and whatever, you have to change this IP address as well. But in most cases, you don't have to change anything. You just have to click on submit, and boom, just like that, Starlink is added in my Home Assistant. I will skip this part. I can add it in an area, but it's not needed for the test. I'll just click on skip and finish. And here it is. I have a bunch of sensors. These are real-time sensors coming from Starlink. And you can see them. Oh, also diagnostic data, also some switches. Everything that I need. Before we go to the first Home Assistant Starlink automation, I want to share that I made a free PDF with this automation YAML code and every other automation that I'll show in this video. You can download it right away. Link is in the video description. Imagine you are on a video call and Starlink suddenly drops. Normally, you may not notice, but what if you have an instant phone notification? This automation do exactly that. I'll leave this screen open and I'll open another tab with Home Assistant again. And in this tab, I'll go to the automation section of Home Assistant. For that, I'll press C button again to invoke this search bar. And I'll search for automations. And then I'll click on navigate automations. And here are my automations. If I click on this create automation button right here in the lower right corner, this dialog will help me create a new empty one, or I can use other things, but I need a new empty automation. I will show you how you can import the YAML code that you can get from the PDF that I told you about. These are the steps. I'll create a new automation. Then I'll go to YAML mode because I want to copy and paste the YAML code from the PDF. I'll delete everything here because I will not need it. I'll replace it with the YAML code that I have in the PDF. I'll copy the code from the PDF like that and I'll just paste it here. That's it. This is the YAML code of this automation. And basically it checks the state of the Starlink connectivity, and if it is off, it will send a message to my phone and it will send a message here in the notification section of Home Assistant, and I'll just have to click on save. The name and the description are already populated, so I'll just click on rename, and I can even go to visual editor again to see what is happening. This is the trigger of the automation. I have no conditions, and if this is true, if this trigger is activated, if the connectivity of Starlink is going to off, to disconnected, then this automation will execute these two actions. It will send a message to my phone and it will send a message here in the notification section with the respective text. Now, let's test this automation. Currently, if I go back to the previous screen, the connectivity sensor is in state connected. If this goes to disconnected, this trigger will be activated and I should receive message. So let's disconnect the Starlink right now. The second the connection goes down, you get a buzz on your phone. Super quick to test as well. Just unplug your Starlink for a minute and you see the message. And Starlink is now disconnected. As you can see here, connectivity sensor is in disconnected state. And I should receive a notification right here. Here it is. Starlink is offline. Check your dish or router. And at the same time, I receive this message. Check your dish or router on my phone. I'm not sure is it visible, but it is on my phone as push notification. So everything is working as expected. And this is pretty useful to notify you when something is wrong. Of course, you may customize this automation. You may add another actions, or you can do whatever you wish. The most important part here, if you wish to work this for you, is to change this action with your phone, because currently it is configured to send messages to my phone. You should change this with yours. Everything is well described in the PDF, so if you need more info about that part, check the PDF. Detailed explanations are there. Quick question for you. What's caused the most Starlink outages in your area? Bad weather, trees, or something else? Next automation will warn you if there is a Starlink dish obstruction for several minutes, and as you probably already know, dish obstructions means bad or no internet. Here are the details. By the way, if you want that automation YAML code as well, just get that free PDF I mentioned. Here is how it works. Open the link that you see on your screen, also available in the video description, and just type your name and email address. Then you get an email from me where you can confirm that you're not some kind of a robot. Then boom, the PDF is yours to have. Inside the PDF, you find step-by-step instructions on how to add Starlink in Home Assistant, all YAML code for all automations from this video, and extra detailed explanations. You also join my newsletter where I'll share news and updates. It's a free service, and if you don't like it, you can unsubscribe anytime with just one click. Now, let's go back to the Home Assistant Starlink dish obstruction automation. A lot of so-called random outages aren't random at all. There's just something blocking your dish. Moving to the next automation that I want to show you. This is activated when there is an obstruction for more than 5 seconds. This is the trigger. If the obstructed Starlink sensor goes to problem for more than 5 seconds, of course, you can change the time to whatever you wish, then activate these two actions. They are pretty similar to the previous. Send a notification to my phone with this title and this message, and send a persistent notification to my Home Assistant, exactly as in the previous automation. To test this automation, I'll have to put something on the Starlink, like a blanket or something, and I'm going to do that right now. And here it is, Starlink dish is obstructed, this is the message, and I have the same message on my phone. Check for trees, birds, or debris. as notification, as push notification, so I don't know what to check exactly when I have problems with my internet. Drop in the comments, what's the strangest thing that's ever blocked your Starlink dish? Okay, so what if the dish isn't blocked, but internet speed is really slow? It might be overheating. Here is how you can know for sure with this Home Assistant Starlink automation. Next automation that I want to show is this one, Starlink Thermal Throttle Alert. So, when I have thermal throttle problems for more than 1 minute, that means when this sensor, thermal throttle, goes from any state to state problem, that means there is a throttling problem with the Starlink dish, then execute the same two actions. Of course, again, these actions can be anything. They can be simple as that or as complex as you wish. And the choice is entirely yours because Home Assistant allows that. Again, the actions are to send a message to my phone with this text and title and send a message to my Home Assistant. These messages are shown here in this section. And again, the message will have this text and this title. So I want to test this as well, but because I cannot overheat my Starlink dish easily, I'll just use the developer tools of Home Assistant to simulate that this sensor will go to problem, from normal to problem. I'll change this automation a bit because if I want to test it right now, I have to wait for 1 minute. I will not do that. I want the change to be active, the trigger to be activated immediately without any waiting. But of course, you can adjust that to your preferences. I'll just save this automation. Now, if this thermal throttle sensor goes to problem, immediately this automation will be triggered. I'll not have to wait for 1 minute. So right now I'm ready to test it and I'll open the developer tools from where I'll be able to simulate the change of the thermal sensor of Starlink. I'll search here for thermal throttle. Here it is, binary sensor. Current state of this binary sensor is off. That means there is no thermal throttle. But if I change it to on and if I click on set state, this automation is immediately triggered, as you can see here. And I have the following message here, as I have the message also on my watch and on my phone, the same message. Starlink thermal throttle is the title and the text is Starlink is thermally throttled, check dish cooling or move to shade. Of course, this text can be anything. I just type this for the demo. And that way I managed to test this automation without overheating my Starlink dish. Starlink throttles performance to protect itself in heat. With this alert, you will know when it's happening before your speeds tank completely. I know you can put Starlink to sleep from the Starlink app, but doing so from Home Assistant is way more fun, as you can include that in your good night routine, or you can also turn on or off other appliances or lights, and basically you can do whatever you want, which is not really possible from the Starlink app alone. So, here is the next automation where the YAML code is in the PDF that I told you about. Now let's see this automation, Starlink sleep at night to save data demo. This is how the automation looks like. Again, the YAML code can be found in the PDF that I told you about with the full explanation and how you can customize this and how you can configure it so you can work for your setup. Basically, the automation is doing the following. It checks the state of my phone's battery. If it goes from not charging to charging, then this automation will be triggered. But here I also have a condition. This condition is doing the following. It checks if the current time is after 11 o'clock and it checks the current day. It should be a work day from Monday till Friday. Of course, this can be customized to your preferences. This is just a demo, and because currently it is after 11 and it is a work day, this condition will pass will return true, and that means if the trigger is activated and because the condition is true, these actions will be activated and executed. And the actions are the following: turn on sleep shadow switch, the switch light right here, so sleep shadow will be turned on. And of course, as usual, I'll send a notification to my phone and a notification to my home assistant. I'll clear these messages, and now I'm going to test this automation. From this window, you can see that my current battery state of my phone is not charging. And if I plug this cable into my phone, it will become charging, and the automation is triggered, as you can see here, and I should receive a message. Yes, I did receive a message on my phone and on my watch as well, because they are connected, and I received this message in my home assistant. Starlink goes to bed, and if I go to my Starlink device info in my home assistant, I'll actually see that the sleep shadow is turned on. That way, you can put to sleep your Starlink when you plug your phone to be charged at night or whatever you wish. And this is pretty useful because usually when I go to bed, it is after 11 or something like that. And immediately I put my phone to be charged overnight. So this activates my sleep routine, and putting Starlink dish to sleep as well in this routine is a great automation that can be used by you as well. This way, Starlink powers down at night and wakes up when you do. Perfect for saving data and energy. Thanks for watching. I'm Kirill, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!